Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. I got a case of the giggles. This is the best time to hit record on a video. So, because you don't want to see angry videos. Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. I can't even do it. All right, so anyway, I'm in a goofy mood. You're going to love this video because the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a place that you have that you can have a layout. Because you guys are always giving me this excuse, I don't have space for a layout. And that's how you talk, actually. That's pretty terrible. Anyway, you do have space for a layout. Everyone does. Watch this. I'm going to show you where your space is. Oh, that was a terrible impression. All right, now every house has one of these, I sure hope. It's the place for a layout. You ready? The bedroom. Yeah, ladies, here's where all the magic happens. Not. But more importantly, under the bed. Look at all this space. And that's what we're going to look at today, is all the space you have under your bed when you clean your room, like I do. So I have a full-size bed, which is 53 inches wide by 75 inches long. That is a standard full bed. And you're going to have basically around 6 inches. Now, of course, some things may vary, but about 6 inches, that's going to be good enough to get something underneath, like this table. This is a 2 foot by 4 foot table. Now, you can go a little bit bigger if you want, but it's a great place to start. A simple table like this, it just simply, the legs pop up, and you got yourself a place to start running trains. Now look, this is all I did. I threw some Kado Unitrack. It's the easiest thing to work with. I had one of those realistic backdrops that I had spray adhesive onto a piece of wood. And I did some clamps. And you could just start with making some scenes. This is end scale. So get started.
If you want to go something more permanent, go with 1x2s. And that's what I did here. I'm making simple framework. It's so light. It is really, really light. And I can just put some very thin plywood on top of this and make a very small but perfect layout that's very light, easy to move.
So this video, really, I just want to tell you that you have the space. That's just an excuse. The next excuse is going to be, I don't have money. This stuff is so expensive. And you are right, the newer stuff, yeah, it's expensive, not gonna lie. But guess what's not expensive? Garage sales, flea markets. If you go to antique stores, you'll find sections there. Here's what's going on. People aren't really paying attention to. The older generation, they're either passing away, they're downsizing, moving somewhere, and a lot of times the kids, the grandkids, they don't know what to do with the train stuff. So they're putting it on Craigslist. They're putting it on Facebook, like Marketplace. They're just going to, yard sales and just getting rid of stuff. And you can get some good stuff for cheap, really, really cheap. And so much of it is still in good condition because they just don't even know what they have. So, yeah, you don't need a lot of money to get started. Get started. If you want to just start with a simple 2 foot by 4 foot, if it's end scale, you got yourself a loop. If it's HO, you got yourself a switching layout. But at least you're starting, and that's the first thing. So I want to talk about excuses real quick. 2022, I had to quit the excuses myself. If you look at how I looked in January 1st of 2022, I was overweight. You know, even through like half the year. I had to make some changes. I had to, I ended the long-term relationship. I had to start focusing on me and my health and my goals. And I stopped eating all the junk food. I stopped eating all that crap. And that stuff, the fast food that I was coming up with excuses of because my work schedule, I'm stuck eating this stuff. That's just excuses. When I stopped eating that, when I started exercising, and at first I couldn't run. I could only run maybe a length of a football field. Now I can do a 5K. You start while you suck, okay? But you got to start. And I'm just tired of people's excuses on why they can't do this or that. And it's all it is excuses. So at 52, I'll be 53 in March. if I can drop 30 pounds in like 6 months, really, and completely change even my desire for junk food, and then get out of my comfort zone. I'm trying new stuff, going in different areas and different things, and just making new friends. And it's tough. It is tough just getting out of your own head and saying, okay, I'm going to try this. I don't know anybody, or I've never done this before, and I'm probably going to embarrass myself. So what? A lot of times, actually, you're going to do better than you think. But each time, you're going to get better. And so, yeah, my life looks a lot different. I know even this looks different. And I look different because I'm just saying enough with the excuses. And that's what I want you guys to take away from this video. Start, whether it's learning how to paint or weather or do scenery or ballast or anything involved with model railroading, just start. See? Here's your pep talk. Tony Robbins got nothing on me. Bye.